The federal government is celebrating a milestone today, 1 year since Prime Minister Anthony Albanese was elected as the country's leader. Live to Federal Politics reporter Rhys D'Alessandro in Canberra. Rhys, 12 months on, does the PM still have the approval of Australians?
Lara, it certainly hasn't all been smooth sailing, but after 12 months, it's safe to say Anthony Albanese overall has been well received. His personal approval ratings remain strong, well ahead of Peter Dutton's. The government is ahead of the opposition in the polls as well. Solidifying this strong belief within caucus, Anthony Albanese's leadership is safe for the rest of this term and beyond, if voters so choose. The government is this morning most proud of its investments in Medicare, cheaper childcare, cheaper medicines, getting wages moving, and its action on climate change. That said, there are some enormous challenges ahead and ones that could do the government damage quickly if it doesn't get them right. The Indigenous Voice to Parliament referendum is the first hurdle, and no result would be a huge blow to the government. And for most voters, cost of living, as we heard from Penelope there, has been the defining issue of the PM's first year, with significant relief still a ways off. There is, of course, a sense of pessimism around the budget for some who say it fell short of expectations for middle Australians.
In just 12 months, the Albanese government's managed to drive up your cost of living and divide the country. Your mortgage bill's a lot higher because of their reckless spending. Your energy bill's a lot higher because of their lack of energy policy that understands you need firming with renewables. And that's also driven your food prices up.
The opposition is seizing on the PM's one-year anniversary this morning, launching a wide-scale ad campaign on Labor's, quote, broken promises and bad decisions. We'll see whether that message sticks, Lara, at the upcoming by-election in the Gold Coast seat of Fadden. It is a safe Liberal seat, but any gain there by Labor is another blow to the Liberals.
Timing is everything, isn't it, Rhys? Thank you.
Welcome back to Weekend Today. Well, amid all of the global meetings, Prime Minister Albanese is also celebrating a milestone today, 1 year since Labor returned to power. Let's bring in today's talkers, Nationals leader David Littleproud and 2GB's Clinton Maynard. Guys, thank you for your time this morning. David, first to you, how do you reckon the PM's going?
Well, look, in just 12 months, the Albanese government's managed to drive up your cost of living and divide the country. Your mortgage bill's a lot higher because of their reckless spending. Your energy bill's a lot higher because of their lack of energy policy that understands you need firming with renewables. And that's also driven your food prices up. But what he's also done is set a path of dividing this nation on The Voice. If he wants to show some leadership now, he has a real opportunity. He has a real opportunity to say this is just about constitutional recognition, not about another layer of bureaucracy. And if it was a set of words that said Indigenous Australians were here first, we made some mistakes, we're better having been together and we're better sticking together, then I think you would find that the whole nation would galvanise behind that and make sure that we get tactile results in closing the gap, which is where most of the disadvantage is and where National Party members represent. And that's why we oppose The Voice, but if it was just about constitutional recognition, we'd be able to do it. So in terms of where the Prime Minister's led us in 12 months, people need to reflect on what's come out of their wallets and what's happened to our nation. On a positive, and you've got to give credit where credit's due, I think on an international stage, I think the Prime Minister and Penny Wong have done a great job. They've built off AUKUS, but they've also made sure that they've enriched many other relationships. So credit where credit's due on foreign policy.
Yeah, some would argue that The Voice will unify the nation, but that remains to be seen. Clinton, to you, he's still leading the polls, but is this a case of the PM doing well, or is Peter Dutton just not the greatest challenger?
Well, if you look at the polls, only 20% of people actually realise that he's a prospect to be a future Prime Minister. He needs to become known, and really, it's going to come down to interest rates. I think that's what's going to decide the next election in 2025. If the Coalition can come up with a real plan on how to bring down inflation and bring down interest rates, mm-hmm. they might have a chance. But at the moment, all the political debate is about The Voice, and really, the Coalition is getting lost on that issue.
Well, today marks 1 year in office for Prime Minister Anthony Albanese, with Labor maintaining a lead in the polls.
But with the cost of living crunch, a housing crisis and also a referendum on the cards, how exactly is the federal government faring? Let's bring in Federal Minister for Finance Katie Gallagher in Canberra. Katie, thanks for your time on Weekend Today. Labor has been in power for 1 year now. Today, what are your party's biggest achievements so far, do you think?
Good morning and thanks for having me on. Well, yeah, it's been a really big year. I think we're doing what we said we'd do all our election commitments. So, you know, mindful of the cost of living pressures on households. So our cheaper childcare policies, our investments in Medicare, helping out with energy bill relief, and also trying to get wages going because that makes a real difference around the household table. Taking action on climate change, another big area where we'd sort of, you know, lost pace with the rest of the world, and we're getting back at the table. And obviously our international relationships, an important part of the work Penny Wong and the PM's doing right now, actually, making sure that people see that Australia's back at the international table and, you know, wanting to be a strong presence in our region. So it's been a very busy 12 months. Sometimes it feels a little bit longer than that.
I can imagine. Minister, one thing the PM couldn't do is get Joe Biden to come to his Quad party. You are the finance minister. How much has that no-show cost taxpayers?
Look, I mean, obviously there was some preparation for putting in place that, you know, and that we'll work that out when the time's right. But, you know, I think we recognise the situation the president was in. He's, you know, the PM said yesterday all politics is local and you have to be there when there's really important debates going on in your own country. So these arrangements shift from time to time. But I think the important thing, the important thing for Australia was that that meeting, the Quad meeting, went on last night with those four leaders to make sure that, you know, the rest of the world sees that India, Japan, the US and Australia are working together to make a safe and prosperous Indo-Pacific region, and that's really the important element that went ahead last night. And hopefully we will be able to host the president here, you know, in the not too distant future.
So as finance minister, you don't know how much the Quad preps cost?
Well, look, you know, obviously there is money that goes into preparing these. You know, that hasn't been finalised. We will get a full, you know, take on that when the time's right. But preparations were being put in place, obviously, as you would expect. When that meeting doesn't go ahead, you know, those arrangements will be unwound and there will be some cost to it, but that hasn't been finalised.
Hey, Katie Gallagher, people are hurting right the way around the country. Housing, cost of living, two really key issues right now for the government. How are you going to ease that burden?
Well, I think you saw in the last budget where we were trying to put in place some of those a cost of living package that didn't actually, you know, impact inflation in a negative way. So there's two challenges going on in the economy, or two main challenges. There's a few, but one of them is the cost of living that pressure that people are feeling, and the other is dealing with this inflation challenge and trying to make sure that it gets back to a more normal range. And so our budget was carefully put together. So where we could make things cheaper, so things like helping out with energy bill relief, cheaper medicines, putting that extra money into Medicare to make sure it does make a difference for people and their costs, but not, you know, making sure that we're not putting so much money into the economy that it makes inflation worse, because that impacts households as well. So, look, you know, this is a balancing act. There's more work to be done. Obviously, we're looking at how we can put more or get our Housing Australia Future Fund bill through the Parliament so we can get, you know, deal with some of the housing shortages, the supply shortages. So there's a lot more work to be done. You know, it doesn't stop at one year. We've got heaps of work on our table that we've got to keep working on, and cost of living, housing is certainly two key ones.
Some would say you guys are still in the honeymoon period. What are Labor's key priorities over the next 12 months?
Well, I think there's a couple that I've just talked about. So cost of living, definitely. What more we can do there to make sure households, you know, are supported where we can. Obviously, housing is one of those key areas. But the work of government goes on. So, you know, making sure we're taking the opportunities that come from the net zero transition. The Voice to Parliament referendum obviously is going to be a key priority in the later part of this year. So there is stacks of work before us. And, you know, you've got a really energetic team that wants to acknowledge the privilege it is to be in government, but also the fact that Australians expect us to put our shoulder to the wheel and work really hard for them, and we intend to do that.
Katie Albo looks like he's having plenty of fun in the top job. He wants Labor to be in power for the next decade. How is he enjoying it?
Oh, look, I think people have seen, you know, what a great Prime Minister he is. I think, you know, he is hardworking, he's authentic, he tells it as it is. And I think people relate to that. And after a decade of, you know, changing Prime Ministers and all the rest of it, I think people are really supportive of the stability and the leadership that he shows. He certainly is a great person to work for. I really enjoy that enormously. And I think people see that, you know, an authentic knockabout guy who's made it to the top job, and he intends to work really hard on behalf of all Australians.
Katie Gallagher in Canberra, thanks so much for your time on Weekend Today.